Hi everyone, welcome to another segment of Short Clip Lessons. My name is Hector Aguilar, and today we will be focusing on how to properly strum on an acoustic guitar. As you can see, the way we are sitting is one of the first things that we need to keep in mind to properly play a strum. Now we're going to use our thumb and our index finger for today, and we will start with our thumb. And a few things to keep in mind as we do a strum is, how do we use the arm to strum, and how do we use our thumb or index to strum? Okay, so one of the things that we want to keep in mind is, if we start from the sixth string with our thumb, we want to make sure that we go straight down in this direction. Now, we do not want this thing right here that we see oftentimes with our beginner students. So remember, don't go out, because what happens is we tend to miss some of the bottom strings if we do that. So you want to make sure that you go straight down with the thumb, and that the arm is also being shifted down. So both the thumb and the arm move down. Now another thing is, we do not want to have this effect right here. That's called rolling a chord. So that is not correct. What we want is a quick attack going down. Now, if you notice, I do have nails on my hand. If you do not have a nail on your thumb, that is perfectly fine. What you're going to do is, you're going to use the belly of the thumb. You're going to put it on the top string, which is string number 6, the same way as you would if you were using your nail. But instead of putting it on the string this way, you're going to put it slightly in front, so that when you strum down, your thumb slides straight down rather than go on the strings and get that nasty sound. Okay, so let's try with the flesh, with the belly of the thumb, and we're gonna go straight down. And what we're gonna do is, we're gonna strum it 4 times. We're gonna go down, and then we're gonna place our thumb back on the 6th string, and then we're gonna strum again, place it back on the 6th string, and so on, okay? So 4 times. So this is the way the exercise would go. It would be strum, position, strum, position, strum, position, strum, position. Do that a few times. Now remember the movements. It's a quick attack going down. This is for down strumming and making sure that you're also using the arm to help you go straight down. And what do we want to avoid? We want to avoid a lot of movement on the wrist and a lot of movement on the arm. Okay, so make sure you're going straight down with the thumb, whether it's with the flesh or with the nail. Okay, so that is using our thumb. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to do the same thing, but with our index finger. We're going to do what we call the elephant. So what you're going to do is, you're going to bring these 3 fingers in, your middle, your ring, and your pinky, into the palm of your hand, or as you're trying to reach, but don't squeeze, just gently bring them in. And then we're going to create what we call the trunk of the elephant with the thumb and the index finger. Okay, now remember, we have 3 knuckles. What you're going to do is, you're going to put the thumb on this bottom knuckle right here, the first knuckle. You're going to put them there as if you were holding an actual plastic pick. Now we're going to bring it to the 6th string, and we're going to do the same thing. The whole concept of the strumming is the same thing, whether you're using your thumb or the index finger. Now we're going to use the thumb as support with our index finger so that it can help us push straight down. But remember, things to avoid. We do not want to play out in that UJ shape. You want to make sure that you go straight down with the arm and the finger. Okay, so now let's do the same thing 4 times. We're going to strum, quick attack, then position the finger back on the 6th string. Ready? And strum, position, strum, position, strum, position, strum, position. Now, you can do this as many times as you want at home, but try to do it in increments of 4 so you can start getting comfortable counting 1, 2, 3, 4. Now remember, the slower we practice this, the faster you will learn it. The faster you try to play this, the less successful you will be. It will sound, what we say, mediocre. It will sound lazy or not proper, okay? So make sure that you practice it very slow so that you can understand the proper way of strumming on the guitar. Now, for those of us that are doing one finger chords, what I want you to do is you're going to start from the third string and you're going to strum straight down. The whole idea is the same thing, but you start from string number three and you would strum quick attack using the arm and the thumb or the flesh if you don't have nail, remember. Still using the thumb, but it's a quick attack. And you would go strum, position, strum, position, strum, position, strum, position. Okay, same thing with the index. You do your little elephant, happy elephant right here. Then you go to string number three and the same thing. Strum, position, strum, position, strum, position, strum, position. All right, so now you're gonna go home and practice this. Well, I guess most of us are home right now, but go ahead and practice this as many times as you need until you properly do a strum on the guitar. That's before even adding any type of chord on the left hand. Thank you.